Good afternoon, Toastmasters and guests.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
And this is the biggest crowd we are seeing in recent weeks. Thank you for that. So when I was in my high school, I was crazy about playing cricket. You know which part of the game I enjoyed most during that time? It was batting. However, with 5 overs each side, for a person coming down the order, batting was a remote possibility every time. So most of the time, I ended up fielding, or rather, looking for the ball which was dispatched into the shrubs. But I could not take it anymore. I spoke to the star cricketers of our time. The result was much more than what I had imagined. I went on to open the innings with full 5 overs at my disposal. At that time, it meant not more than getting what you want. However, when I look back now, I see it as one of my initial moments to influence and convince people. When we are into our professional lives, more often than not, we are into a job only, not bothering about influencing or convincing people around us or above us. However, the ability to influence and convince people is a key skill for your success. If you are in Toastmasters, there is a high chance that you develop that skill. When you are delivering your speeches, you are taking control, taking charge of your thoughts and communicating them. That's when the seed of leadership is sown. When you grow in Toastmasters, you take up roles like evaluator, mentor, or officer. The seed germinates. And that seed germinates into a tree. That's when you realize that the Toastmasters has helped you in becoming a leader. And that is true to the motto of Toastmasters, where leaders are made. Even if you look outside of Toastmasters, that's how leaders are made. The great leaders are great orators too. If you look at political leaders like Mahatma Gandhi or spiritual leaders like Swami Vivekananda, initially they communicated their thoughts, influenced and convinced people. Then they became great leaders. So if you're a Toastmaster and you're applying yourself truly to the program, it's just a matter of time where you want to become a leader or be a leader. In my club, I have always looked up to leaders in my club. I have seen leaders like Ananda, Anupriya, Induja, Ram, Uma, and recently Vaibhav. So now it's my turn to take up the leadership role. My first priority would be to strengthen our mentorship program, which is key for the accelerated growth of our members. Secondly, I want to make the sessions more relevant so that people can learn the art of public speaking quickly. And finally, we are in a time of transition wherein we are moving from the traditional Toastmaster program to the new program called Pathways. So here we have 10 tailor-made paths for whatever goals you may have. If you want to be a great presenter, we have a path. A dynamic leader, an effective coach, or a persuasive influencer, all have paths. And these paths are relevant to the times we live in. So with these goals in mind, I am sure every member of the club will have some takeaway from every session of orators. So, of course, we will have fun along the way. So I am excited about the next 6 months. Are you excited?
Yes.
Great. Orators have given me a lot in the form of appreciations, genuine feedbacks, opportunities to host events, and some great friendships, which form my cherished memories. It's truly an honor to be a leader of a club which has nurtured my growth. And by now, I have also realized that the true joy is in giving. And I think it's now my time to give back the precious gifts I have received from all of you. Over to Toastmasters.